Hello friends, I hope you are doing good. In this video I am going to explain the functionality and the features of our OTP login WordPress plugins. Okay, so as you can see, these all are my plugins. Okay, and here you can find the OTP login. Okay, so I have already installed this plugin, so it's showing to disable as active. Okay, so from here you can find our plugins and you can install it. Okay, so let me show you the settings of the our OTP WordPress plugin. Okay, so there are two ways to access the WP login setting. Here you can find the OTP login settings under settings, and you can find the OTP login settings on admin menu bar as well. Okay. So before I start the explain the functionality of our plugins, I want to say, if you have any query about our WordPress plugins, or if you want to give any suggestions to improve our plugin functionality, then you can leave your message in video comment box. Okay, and I will also provide you download link of our OTP login in video description box, so you can easily find download it from WordPress official website. Okay, so if you like my plugin functionality, then please do not forget to leave your valuable feedback on video comment box and as well as on WordPress official site as well. Okay, so let me start to show you the setting of our plugin. Here you can see there are two options. First is to enable the OTP login, and second to define the redirect URL. Okay, so to start the work on OTP login, you must have need to enable checkbox. Okay, and here you can define the URL. Okay, as I am here defining my account page. Okay, as I am here defining the redirect URL, my account page. So once user will logged in, it will redirect to our my account page. Okay, so let me save it. I have saved the page, and let me show you how you can add it on your website. Okay, so add plugins pop up using CSS class, CSS using class name. Okay, and class name is OTPL hyphen popup. Okay, so you can add this class in any attribute like hyperlink or div or span. Okay, and you can use it on your website template file and your page editor or in widget, and you can use it in your menu as well. Okay, so website menu section as well. Okay, so here I have given also a example, so you can use this example to publish the login page. Okay, so let me show you how you can add the login link in your admin menu bar. Okay, so let me show. Okay, here you can see this is our menu section. Okay, as I have recently added this menu bar here. Okay, let me show you. To add the login link, here I need to put the hashtag custom. You need to add a new custom link. Okay, so add, and after add you will see the class CSS class name. Here you will need to copy the class name from plugin settings page, this one. Okay, and copy the class name and paste it. Okay, if you are not able to see this section, this field for to define the class name, then you can easily enable it from screen option section. Okay, here you need to check this box. You can see the CSS class name section has been gone and it's showing right now. So you can enable the CSS class name here if you let me save it and in front end. Okay, so when I'm going to click, nothing is happening because I have already logged in my local WordPress site, so it will not allow me to open the pop-up. Okay, so that's why I am going to refresh the page. This page I have created in window, I have opened in my private window. So here login pop-up should be open after click on this. Yes, so you can see the OTP verification pop-up which is showing here. Okay, so same way you can add the class that I have already added in menu section. You can also add this class anywhere on your website, in your page template, in your temp email from backend editor, or in widget sidebar. So anywhere you can just add the link here and you will able to add the pop-up login pop-up. Okay, so let me show how it will work. I am going to try to login using my email ID and valid email. Yes, email ID validation is working here. So this time email ID I have entered, user does not exist. It means the user not exist with this email ID. Okay, so let me change it to test@gmail.com, mail.com. okay, so this also user not exist in account, so test@gmail.com. yes, this user is exist in our WordPress admin, so that's why it's going to my second step. Okay, and here you can see the OTP. okay, so for testing purpose I have enabled the display the OTP in console bar. Okay, so I am going to, as on my local system I am not able to get the email. Okay, so that's why I have display the menu in console bar. Okay, so let me click on this. Okay, let me resend OTP here. I can see OTP. okay, so this is my correct OTP, and now let me try to with wrong OTP. okay, so OTP does not means OTP is validation is working fine. Okay, if I am trying to enter the text here, okay, so you can see invalid OTP. if I am going to define the more than 6 digit, in that case the same error, invalid OTP, means you will require to insert a valid 6 digit OTP code here. Okay, otherwise you will not able to login in your WordPress admin. Okay, so here we have given the 2 layer of security, so no one can easily access your website login page. And this is basically OTP is the more secure compared to our user normal password. Okay, so let me submit the OTP with valid OTP, and here you can see I am able to login and I am going to redirect my account page because I have all defined the login page redirection here, my account. Okay, so you can see the I am able to login here and my OTP is working fine. Okay, and if I will try to login again, okay, so it will not show again because we have added the condition. So for not logged in, if you are already logged in, then the login pop-up box will be not displayed for you. So I hope all settings is clear for you how you can add this. Okay, and let me show you how you can add this and widget. Okay, here you can see a widget, and I am going to just add the HTML OPP login and save it. Let me show you. Sorry, here first of all I will need to log out my current as I will already login. Okay, so if this one I have added in my widget section login. Okay, so here you can see this is the login. Okay, and I am able to login here. You can see login, When I'm going to click, you are able to see the pop-up of login, and you will click on this, then you will also able to log in. Okay, so in this way you can easily add the login pop-up, OTP login pop-up on your website. Okay, and I hope you will enjoy our plugins, and this feature of our plugins will be helpful for you to give a extra layer, security layer, to login into your website. Okay, and that's it for today. If you like my video, if you like my plugin functionality, then please do not forget to leave your valuable feedback in comment box, and subscribe to our channel to get some more useful videos about WordPress from our channel. Okay, so that's it for today.